Hi guys, welcome to Tutora MBT video. Today I'm going to demonstrate on how to do a stack bar based on the four Likert scales, and this stack bar need to represent 100% of these four scales. As you can see, the first one stands for strongly agree, the second for agree, the third for disagree, and the fourth one for strongly disagree. Now, how to make this type of graph based on these four scales? And to do so, I'm just gonna go take you through my data. As you can see, guys, these are the data set. The data set is about student nurse in a clinical area. It means that student that that are doing training at hospital, at different department, they are not showing up at work. So we constructed these questions and handed them over to them and see what will be their response. According to the observation that are not showing up during their training session. This is the way the data is set. You can see we have those four scales here. We have agree, strongly disagree, agree. So these four scales can also be viewed in the variable scale so you can have a good idea of what the data looks like. So if you go into variable view, you will see that the question that we ask at these on, these are the questions. So the reason for absenteeism and the cause. So they give the reason. And the four scales that we're talking about, it means that the one, remember I showed you one, the values on the data view. This one stands for strongly agree, two for agree, three for disagree, and four for strongly agree. So when you're looking at the bar, at the stack bar graph for percentage, you need to set your data on the ordinal, not on the scale or nominal. So you need to make them to be ordinal for you to be able to run the analysis. So if you leave them on a scale, it's going to be a little bit tricky for you to run the analysis. But if you change your data into ordinal scale, then it's going to be easy for you to run the analysis. So this is how you need to set your data. To do a stack bar for this data analysis, you need to go to analyze, tables, custom tables, and click OK. Once this panel opens, you can reset it and say all, and just select the question that you want to analyze. These are the question that you wanted to analyze. Let's say I wanted to analyze this from 21 to 25. So these are the questions that I wanted to, because I think like they all are related, because they're talking about mostly the clinical area. So I want to see what will be their response in terms of these four or five questions. So once you drop them there in the custom table, everything you need to do before you run the analysis, you have to go to category position, where you have to change the default to row in columns, the row labels in columns. Then you go to summary statistics. You click. Remember, I told you are looking for the percentage, so you're not looking for the count. You remove the count and go for percentage zero. So you go there and click apply. So yeah, there's nothing much to do. The only thing you do, I don't want this row to show up. So what I don't do is to hide them and click OK. Here we go. This is the data that we just generated, the table that we have created from the analysis. So now what next here is to transpose. The scale must go to the XY, and then this question must go to the top. So it's basically sweeping the position of the question and the scales. So what you have to do is double click the table. Once the table is highlighted, go to the tabs and look for pivot. There is pivot. Click on pivot. The next panel shows you two options. Just click on transpose rows and columns. You click on rows and columns. Boom. This is our custom table that is transformed. As you can see, values were this side and this were on top. So the configuration of the table is well set. So what you have to do next is to highlight the data. And once you highlight them, right click, go to this panel and look for created graph. Go to bar graph and click. All you have to do is to double click the graph so that the chart editor can appear. And once chart is appear in the chart editor, double click again in one of the bars. You see that the bars will be highlighted. And the next step here is to go to the panel that will assist us for changing and editing the graph. So you go to that panel and click on the variable. See the variable is there. Now, once you get the variable, go to where it says statistic and look for cluster. Click on cluster, scroll down and look for the stack. Well, then click on stack, then apply. Boom, here is the graph. So this can also be excuse me. So this graph can also be edited through this panel. So you go to the panel, you can reduce it to, I can put this 50 or 45. Okay, let's go 45. You will see that once you apply, then there will be a change in the size of the graphs. You see, this is the 100% scale. This is the 100%. I can increase this to 12, as well as the legend. I can put the legend also size 12, so that can be visible to everyone. Then this is how you can also even change, you know, the position of your legend, if you want strongly to be on top or disagree to be at the bottom. So it's up to you. You can change all the scale position and the color also will change. So this is our bar graph that is based on the four Likert scales and represent 100% per column. So you can see all these four scales I divided into percentages to make it a total of 100. So this is how you can run your stack bar using SPSS.